Speech of debate is now adjourned. The bill is referred to the House Committee.
Secretary for Development, President, members of the Council, good morning. I move the second reading of the Construction Workers Registration Amendment Bill 2014. The purpose of the bill is to amend the Construction Workers Registration Ordinance Cap 588 so as to commence the remaining phases of prohibition, and that is on so as to fully implement the construction workers registration system. In 2007, the ordinance was enacted so as to enhance skill levels of workers for trade tests, so as to enhance quality of works, and to enhance the occupational status of construction workers by providing statutory recognition of skill levels, and to build up a quality culture in the construction sector, and to provide more reliable data on construction labor force to facilitate manpower planning and training. And since December 2005, we've been registering construction workers, and the number of workers have rose from 225,000 in 2007 to 332,000 in December 2013. To facilitate graduate adaptation of the trade, we have gone for a phased implementation approach. Starting from 2007, workers that are not registered are not allowed to carry out construction work on construction sites. As a worker possessing a green card may register to satisfy the requirements under Phase 1, relevant industry stakeholders, including workers, subcontractors, and employers, can in general meet the requirements. Regarding the part requiring relevant trade register workers for designated trades only. Now, workers that are not registered or not under the instruction or supervision of a relevant skilled registered workers are not allowed to carry out a trade, carry out works in that particular trade. We have consulted relevant stakeholders, including trade unions and also trade associations, and their concerns can be summarized as follows. First, there are quite a number of workers that concentrate on one or two of the skill sets of a trade, or some workers may only carry out trade works of minor scale and nature, and they are often involved in a number of trades. They may not be able to register as semi-skilled or skilled workers, and they can no longer work independently under relevant trades, and their livelihood would be affected. Secondly, the construction industry has the practice of deploying workers of a trade to carry out other trade works of similar nature. For instance, a worker that knows how to pave tile fitting may be deployed to build bricks. Once the prohibition requirements are removed, then they may no longer be able to carry out such works. And most stakeholders, trade association in particular, asked for a one-off grandfathering arrangement for senior workers. And in carrying out emergency construction works, there may not be sufficient time to arrange or to deploy sufficient registered workers to carry out the trade, and therefore the requirement may not be feasible. And some small and medium-sized construction companies have asked for time to adapt to the system. Now, they are now trying to adapt to the new requirements of the Minor Works Control System under the Building Minor Works Regulation launched in December 2010, and they would like the remaining phase of prohibition be implemented at a later stage. So since 2010, we have been conducting extensive discussion with the relevant stakeholders. The bill has addressed their concerns. In 2010, we set a working group to study the issues and explore solutions. And in 2011, we set up a review committee for the ordinance, we started to carry a detailed discussion with stakeholders and formally proposals for amendments. In early to mid-2012, we consulted the sector, and in June the same year, together with the former Construction Workers Registration Authority, we organized construction sector forums. And then we also set up staff for a task force to finalize the proposals in accordance with views collected during the consultation. And in between September and October last year, together with the Construction Industry Council, we organized briefing sessions for the sector to explain to them the details of the bill. In general, the bill are in agreement with our proposed amendments and therefore been included into the bill. May I now brief you on the salient points of the bill. First, we propose to subdivide trades into trade division for the basis of registration to facilitate workers to register against designated trade divisions according to their respective modular skills. To encourage multi-skill development of workers and provide a ladder for skill enhancement, we also propose to create a trade division master for each group of trade divisions as appropriate. We also allow workers possessing registrations for a group of trade divisions to register as master skilled worker. Without affecting the safety of construction works and without affecting the requirements of other pieces of legislation, we will exempt emergency construction works and small-scale construction works from the remaining prohibition provisions. Within the first 40 hours when a contractor is made aware of an emergency construction work, he can arrange general workers to carry out emergency construction works to buy time to deploy skilled workers to carry out the relevant works. And contractors can also deploy general workers to carry out small-scale construction works involving a number of trades. We propose to allow the Secretary for Development to formally regulations for such arrangements. The trade is of the view that for some senior workers, they've been in the trade for no less than 10 years and they should have acquired skills of a certain level. So we propose to introduce a one-off grandfathering arrangement so that for senior workers who have possessed an aggregate of not less than 10 years relevant work experience, well, they can be registered. So we will start from larger scale works proceeding to smaller scale works to allow the trade to adapt to the new arrangements. So we will only consider the consider maintenance works under term contract for maintenance and minor construction works, including works under construction contract with a total value of all construction operations not exceeding 10 million, as well as class 1 and 2 minor works under BMWR to be regulated under the remaining phase of prohibition at a later stage. And then we have got 23 relevant documents. The issuing authority are in agreement with our proposal. We propose to amend the relevant legislation so that workers' ID card can be regarded as acceptable. And this is in accordance with the mode of operation of the industry, so that when registered workers are deployed to a designated trade, they can continue with their daily work, and contractors can continue to make arrangements for the remaining construction works. And we will continue to recruit and train local workers so as to increase manpower supply. We will carry out massive publicity to let workers understand the new requirements so that they can register to become semi-skilled or skilled workers as soon as possible. And therefore, the requirements that trade-specific registered workers can only be deployed to designated duties should not have any negative impacts on manpower supply and construction costs. On the 20th of December, last year, we briefed the development panel on the bill, and they have no objection to our introducing the bill to the council. The registration system will be a major milestone in the development of our construction sector. This will be conducive to the long-term development of the industry and to help build up a culture of quality. And this is also important for enhancing the occupational status of workers. We believe the system will encourage more young people to join the construction trade. I urge members to support the bill and complete the scrutiny of the bill for commencement as soon as possible. Thank you. I now propose the question, and that is the Construction Workers Registration Amendment Bill 2014 be read the second time. In accordance with the rule procedure, the debate is now adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.